There once was a little tailor who was very cheeky cat. The little tailor was sewing one zip and nibbling on a thick slice of bread and jam when several big fat flies started buzzing around the jam pot. Get lost, buzzers! He flicked at the flies with his sewing, but the seven insects still buzzed around the jam pot. I'll show you! He jumped off from the sewing stool and fetched his broom and hit it swiftly on top of the jam pot. Well, look at that! The little cheeky tailor quickly ran himself up a white belt. He decorated it with crystal beads and with the words 7 at 1 blow. Then he buckled it around his waist and stood in front of a mirror. Oh my! What a splendid chap like me doing in a dingy little workbook like this. I should be up and about in public. With that, he left his sewing shop for the last time and set off down the road, humming merrily to himself and tipping his hat politely to all he met. Everyone was gossiping about the hero who had killed 7 at 1 blow. Just imagine slaying 7 men at 1 blow. Oh no! Eventually, even the king got to hear of the very small but very brave champion, and he ordered him to the palace at once.
You see, my problem is this,
the king explained, bending low so that he could see eye to eye with the little cheeky tailor.
There are 2 giants who keep robbing my villagers and killing my subjects. If you get rid of them, I'll give you half of my kingdom.
And your daughter's hand in marriage. Mm-hmm. 2 giants mean nothing to me. Don't forget that I have killed 7 at 1 blow. The little cheeky tailor bravely took to the road, which led him into a forest. He found the giants. They were both asleep under a huge shady oak tree. He picked up 2 large round petals and tucked them into his shirt. Then he crept up to the tree, climbed nimbly in the branches. Plop! He threw the first stone down at the first sleeping giant and hit him smack on the nose. Ouch! The wounded giant thought it was done by the other giant and told him to mind his manner. High up in the tree, the little cheeky tailor giggled and dropped his second stone.